Hello YouTube, time for a video again. Well, today I'm going to do like an update on Stroppy, my flower on. All right, Stroppy, mate. There we go. Look, come on, Stroppy, it's your turn today to be on the video. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to feed him some earthworms and just have a little waffle and chat. I'm going to see if I can get the missus to put her hand in the tank. Do you think she'll put her hand in? I hope she gets bitten. I hope she gets bitten. Then I can laugh at her. Let's get on it! Right, let's get on with this update with this flower on. So this is Stroppy. He's a nice big chunky flower on. He's a low grade super red dragon. And I've had him about, I would say he got to be about maybe 5 year old now. And some people say these flower ons don't have a very long, excuse the glare, but people say these flower ons don't have a very long life expectancy, which is true to a certain extent, because they're crossbred with all different species, so that has an effect on the life expectancy. But in my opinion, one of the biggest things what kills people's flower ons is incorrect diet. I see too many people feeding things like prawns and mussels and too much protein food, because basically a lot of these flower ons, a lot of it comes from the Vishajay species, which are primarily like vegetarian. So I'd lay off on the protein meaty foods and stick to pellets. Now old Stroppy, he eats 90% of his diet as high calorie pellets, and he's doing fine. Never no digestion problems. He's always pooing. He don't poo white stringy poos. But when he has a treat, the protein treat what I like to feed him is earthworms. I love feeding earthworms. I don't think you can go far wrong feeding earthworms. Easy to digest. Doesn't mess the intestines up. Don't get parasites. So what we'll do, there's some earthworms. What I'll do, instead of me putting my hand in feeding the earthworms, I'll get the missus on it, eh? That'll be a laugh, won't it? Get the missus playing with the earthworms, feeding old Stroppy. She might want to rub his cock. Right, here we are then, here's the missus. She's got she's got the tub of worms. Let's have a laugh. This time it might be a laugh. She might get bitten instead of me. Right, love. Let's see you put your hand in. Show Stroppy the worm first. There he mate. He loves his own protein worms, don't you?
Don't bite me, Stroppy.
Get your hand in. Get your hand in there, love. Get your hand in. But you're like deeper. You let go of it. You let go too quick. Look at Stroppy munching it. Let him get it down him. Don't put another one in yet till he's
showing.
Yeah, but let's let him look. There we are. He knows what's coming, don't you, mate?
It is at that.
He's at that one, like. So put your hand in nice and deep.
Bye.
Do as you told, woman. Put your hand in nice and deep and don't let go. There it goes, look. We've got a reflection out there. There it goes. He's chewing on like a laggy band. It's like a tug of war. We've got a reflection. It's like a tug of war. Go on, Strops, boy. Get her fingers.
Stroppy, don't.
He's got a gob full. He's doing it gently. How come? Let go of it then. Let it go.
Ow!
Did he get you?
Yeah.
There's a bit of worm floating down there. Right, just give him... I'll put this on pause. We'll just give him 5 minutes to munch them down, and then we'll give him another one. Right, he's at that worm, he's crunched it down. It takes him a bit to get them down. Right, love, get your hand in there and rub and give him a stroke. Just get your hand in, woman. Yeah. Get your hand in. Put your hand right in, and then he won't bite. That's it. Look, that's it. Stroke him. That's it. You get it in, woman. He'll not hurt you.
He bit me before, innit?
No, stroke him on it. He likes his cock rubbed. He's a bit like his dad, innit? He likes his cock stroked. The cock, by the way, if you're new to fish keeping, the cock is the lump on top of his head. So we're not being rude, but put your hand in and just feel him.
No, because he's going to bite.
Ah, oh, go on. That's it. Give him a nice little bit of love. Right, should we try him another worm?
Yeah. Here's Stroppy.
There he goes. That's what he's waiting for. I apologise about the reflections behind me, the glare, but don't tease him too much. There he goes. Get your hand right in. Now he's gone. Let's get it.
Get it, Charles.
There, let him chew that one up. Yeah, so what was we saying earlier? Oh, she's rubbing his cock. She's rubbing his sides as well. Yeah, what we're saying earlier, like, that'll be enough now for his earthworm. So 99% of the time we feed him on pellets, which is good for his digestive system. Easy for him to digest, and to get all the vitamins and minerals and all the proteins we need. And the only treat what I'll feed him is give him 2 or 3 worms now and again as a treat. So I'm a big believer, if you start feeding them like bits of tilapia meat and prawns and mussels, and all that meaty food. I've done it myself in the past. I learned the hard way. You'll do that and then they'll get all bunged up. They'll start doing white stringy poo. And then it's on a downward spiral. And then they could probably end up losing them. So this flower on's a 5-year old. Some people say they've only got a life expectancy of about 5 years. But we'll see. So we'll see how long poor old Stroppy lasts. It's my turn to put my hand in now. I'm not frit of him. I'm a proper man. Come on, Strops, me old boy. And, oh, God, he bites me. Look, I'll put it, hold him against the tank, like, then see how big he is. He's a really big old fish. So, like I said, I wouldn't feed the, oh, bloody hell. He's got bloody sharp teeth. He's right clumsy. He's really, really clumsy at swimming, but this is a low grade flower run. I would say this is Trimac and Sinspillum. So, like the Sinspillum, a vegetarian type of fish. So, why would you want to give the Trimac? Why would you want to give the Trimac? Why would you want to give your flower run loads of protein and bung him up? Yeah, so, ouch, you got it. He's got it. Why did you bite you?
No, because he loves me.
No, he don't.
You're bleeding.
Yeah, he's doing it gently now. He's getting pissed off. Anyway, we better leave old Stroppy in peace. And I hope I haven't waffled on too much about the flower oils, but like I said, I think some of the reason why they have a short lifespan is people keep putting, like, tilapia meat and prawns, mussels, and all this. Like, I try to make all these concoction foods to try to make his cock grow. But a lot of that is down to genetics. I don't believe whatever you feed your flower on, I don't think it's going to make any difference to the size of his cock. Genetics plays the most part. But look from behind, how thick this his head is. That's a huge knuckle hump or cock. Anyway, I think I'm pissing him off now. Ow! No, I'll just let me get my hand out. It does look like he's doing it gently. But look, can you see, like, on there, on my knuckles? Can you see all that? He's got really, really sharp teeth. But he's clumsy. He's a clumsy old boy.
But we love him.
Yeah, but we love him. I've just dried my hands. When it's underwater, it doesn't look like it's bleeding much like. But like I said, they don't look like they've got teeth, do they? But they're like really, really small, just inside the gum, and they're like blooming razors.
They're
light. Yeah, so anyway, shut up waffling. Let's shut up waffling, and we'll move on. Right, it's time to wrap this video up now. I think we've waffled on about Stroppy enough. Like, as you know, I'm sat here with Wolfie, me dove eye. So let's just recap. Don't I waffle on about a load of garbage? In my opinion, one of the biggest killer of the flareon is inappropriate diet. You're better off sticking to pellets, in my opinion. You tell me your opinion in the comments below. You might think I talk a load of garbage. I probably do, actually, but that's what I found. Like, in the past, many years ago, when the flareons first came on the scene, I paid a lot of money for one or two flareons, and I used to feed them on mussels and prawns and all the fancy pellets and that. And they only lived a couple of years, and they used to get white poo, and they used to pass away. But since I've been feeding just 99% pellets and the odd earthworm for a treat, old Stroppy's doing really, really well. We'll see how long he lives before he croaks. Yeah, I believe the flareons have been a bit like electric blue Jack Dempsey's. They've been overbred. The same happening in the fish hobby. What's happening with pedigree dogs? I mean, you buy, for example, the British Bulldog is nowhere near as healthy as what they used to be many, many years ago. They have all these hereditary problems from interbreeding. Well, to me, the same's happening with the flareons and the electric blue Jack Dempsey's. Anyway, shut up waffling. Shut up waffling, Woods. About time to wrap this video up. And if you've watched it to the end, yeah, you're a superhero. So, like what I'm going to say, if you've watched it to the end, just text Wolfie. Until next time, happy fish keeping to you all. Ta-ra!